Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a complete course for the CCNP ENCOR, Enterprise Core exam. In this lab, we will review some of the MTU concepts we covered in the previous lecture video. First, let's look at the topology. R1 and R2 are both connected to an ISP, and we will later build a GRE tunnel between R1 and R2 over the ISP infrastructure, which is represented by this single router. In the lab notes, I have the information for each subnet. The R1 ISP connection is 203.0.111.0/24, with R1 as .1 and the ISP as .100. The R2 ISP connection is 203.0.112.0/24, with R2 as .2 and the ISP as .100. Then there is also a segment off of R2's G01 interface, connected to R3 via switch 1. The subnet is 192.168.23.0/24, with R2 as .2 and R3 as .3. So let's get started with the lab. The first step says to do an extended ping from R1 to R2, set the DF bit, and do a sweep of sizes from 1496 bytes to 1505 bytes. Then we'll see which pings succeed and which fail, but you should already know the answer if you watched the lecture video. So, I'll go on R1. And first, I'll just ping R2 normally to make sure all devices have the necessary ARP entries. Enable. Ping 203.0.112.2. Okay, now let's do the extended ping. The command is simply ping. Now let's go through the prompts. I'll hit enter to ping using IP, which means IPv4. Next, I'll enter R2's IP, 203.0.112.2. I'll set the repeat count as 1. Since we are doing a size sweep, this means one sweep. I'll leave the datagram size at 100 bytes. Since we are doing a size sweep, we will actually specify the sizes later. This value won't be used. As for the timeout, I'll change it to 1, just so the failed pings fail faster. Now I'll enter Y to enable extended commands. Without that, you can't specify things like the DF bit. No for ingress ping. No need to specify the source interface or IP. It only has one connected interface anyway. 0 for DSCP and type of service are fine. And Y for the DF bit. No to validate reply data. I'll accept the default here and now type V for verbose and hit enter again to accept it. Verbose means the ping output will display more information like the size of each ping. Now Y for sweep range of sizes, with a minimum size of 1496 bytes, and a maximum of 1505, and an interval of 1, meaning each ping will increase in size by 1 byte. And let's do the ping. So, the first 5, requests 0 to 4, succeed. That's because they fit within the default MTU of 1500 bytes. Requests 5 to 9, however, fail. That's because they are larger than the MTU of 1500 bytes, and we also set the DF bit, so R1 couldn't fragment them into smaller packets. Now let's return to the lab notes. Step 2 says to configure a GRE tunnel between R1 and R2, and the subnet should be 192.168.12.0/30, with R1 as .1 and R2 as .2. It also asks what the IP MTU of the tunnel interface is. Again, you should be able to answer that question already, but let's confirm after we configure it. I'll go back on R1. Now, GRE tunnel configuration wasn't a CCNA topic, but I did introduce it in the CCNA course and review it in the previous lecture video. Also, if you don't remember how to configure the tunnel, try a Google search for something like Cisco GRE configuration. It's a good opportunity to practice your Google skills. Anyway, GRE configuration is an ENCOR topic, so we'll cover it in more depth later in the course. Now let's configure it. Conf T, interface T0, that's tunnel 0. First, I'll configure the IP. IP address 192.168.12.1. 255.255.255.252. Now the tunnel source. tunnel source, and here I can specify either the source IP address, which would be G00's IP, or specify the interface itself. I'll just do G00. Now the destination. Tunnel destination, and then R2's G00 IP, 203.0.112.2. That's all on R1, but the tunnel can't be built until R2's side is also configured. So let's go on R2. Enable conft interface T0, IP address 192.168.12.2, 255.255.255.252. Just to demonstrate that either method works, I'll specify the source IP this time instead of the interface. Tunnel source 203.0.112.2. And now the destination, R1's G00 interface. Tunnel destination 203.0.111.1. Okay, the tunnel should be working now. To test, I'll ping R1's tunnel interface from here on R2. Do ping 192.168.12.1. Okay, the pings work. Now, what is the IP MTU of the tunnel interface? Remember, GRE takes an IP packet and then adds a GRE header and then another IP header on top of it before it is encapsulated in an Ethernet frame and sent out of the physical interface. Those additional GRE and IP headers add a total of 24 bytes to the packet size. So if the internal IP packet uses the default MTU of 1500 bytes, the total will be 1524 bytes. Now, that 1524 byte packet can still be fragmented, because the outer IP header can be used for fragmentation. But we want to avoid fragmentation whenever possible. So the tunnel interface should use an MTU 24 bytes less than the default, and 1500 minus 24 is 1476. Let's check. Do show IP interface T0. Up near the top of the output, you can see the MTU, 1476 bytes as expected. Now let's return to the lab notes for the next step. Step 3 says to configure the IP MTU of the tunnel interfaces to 1500. Then we'll try a couple 1500 byte pings, one without the DF bit set, and one with it. First, I'll configure R2's interface. IP MTU 1500. Okay, and then R1. IP MTU 1500. Okay, now let's try a couple pings. First without the DF bit, and the size should be 1500. I'll ping R2's tunnel interface. Do ping 192.168.12.2, size 1500. Okay, the internal ping packet size was 1500 bytes, meaning with the additional GRE and IP headers, the total size is 1524 bytes, larger than the MTU. However, the ping succeeded, so that means the oversized packets must have been fragmented. Let's check. To do that, you can use the command do show IP traffic interface G00, since that's the physical interface that actually sends the tunneled packets. In the sent section, it says 5 fragmented into 10 fragments. So the 5 ICMP ECHO requests were indeed fragmented. And actually R2's replies, also 1500 bytes, were fragmented too. In the received section, it also says 10 fragments, 5 total reassembled. Okay, now let's try a ping with the DF bit set. What do you expect to happen this time? Let's see. Do ping 192.168.12.2, size 1500, DF bit. Okay, this might be unexpected for you. Even though the DF bit was set, meaning these packets can't be fragmented, the pings succeed. Let's check the traffic statistics again. Do show IP traffic interface G00. Now the fragment count has been increased, 10 fragmented into 20 fragments. Why did that happen, even though we set the DF bit? I didn't cover this specifically in the lecture video, but it's because the DF bit is only set on the internal ping packet. However, That packet is then encapsulated in a GRE header and then another IP header. And that new IP header actually doesn't have the DF bit set by default. So, R1 is actually able to fragment that packet, even though in the internal IP packet the DF bit is set. Now, it is possible to change that behavior. You probably don't have to know this for ENCOR, but knowing a little extra never hurt. The command on the tunnel interface is tunnel path MTU discovery. That's right, that's the path MTU discovery I mentioned in the lecture video. This command tells the router that if the DF bit is set in the internal packet, it should also be set on the external IP header. That allows PMTUD to be used over the tunnels. Otherwise, the packets would be fragmented, as we demonstrated here, and end hosts can't properly perform path MTU discovery. Now I'll do that same ping again. Do ping 192.168.12.2, size 1500, DF bit. And this time the pings fail because they can't be fragmented. The DF bit in the internal packet was copied to the external IP header. Anyway, let's return the MTU to the default. To remove the settings, you can do no IP MTU, and that will return it to the default of 1476. Just in case, I'll check. Do show IP interface T0. Okay, it's 1476 again. And now on R2 also. No IP MTU. Now let's return to the lab notes for the final step. Step 4 says to send some pings from R1 to R3 and troubleshoot the problem. So we'll send a couple pings from R1 to R3 with a size of 1476. First setting the DF bit and then without it. According to the instructions, these pings won't succeed, but let's try first. I'll return to R1 and end to return to privileged exec mode. First, I'll try a regular ping, which is 100 bytes by default on Cisco iOS, by the way. Ping 192.168.23.3. Okay, notice the U here in the ping output. That means R1 received an ICMP unreachable message from one of the devices in the route to the destination, meaning that device doesn't have a route to the destination. I'm guessing that's the ISP, since R2 should have a directly connected route. Let's check R1's routing table. Show IP route. Okay, R1 has a default route to the internet, but no other routes except its connected and local routes. So to reach the R2 R3 subnet, it is sending the packet to the ISP, but the ISP probably has no route to the destination. It doesn't know about its customers' internal networks. We can check which device R1 receives the unreachable message from with a debug. Debug IP ICMP. Now let's try the ping again. Ping 192.168.23.3. Again, the ping fails, and we get debug messages, indicating that the unreachable message is indeed coming from the ISP, 203.0.111.100. Anyway, we don't need the debug anymore, so I'll disable it with undebug all. Now, the ISP router is not our infrastructure, it's the ISP's infrastructure. So although in this lab you can freely access the router and configure a route on it, we should use another method. Let's fix the issue by configuring a route on R1 to the R2 R3 subnet, and tell it to use the tunnel to send the traffic, by configuring R2's tunnel IP as the next hop. Conf T, IP route, 192.168.23.0, 255.255.255.0, and R2's tunnel interface IP is 192.168.12.2. Okay, now I'll use end, and let's try that ping. Ping 192.168.23.3. Finally, the ping works. Now let's actually try those pings stated in the instructions. Ping 192.168.23.3, size 1476, DF bit. Okay, the ping fails. How about without the DF bit? Will it work then? Ping 192.168.23.3, size 1476. It seems we're still not getting replies. So there's still more troubleshooting to do to find the cause. I hope you've tried this lab yourself and troubleshooted the issue. But for the sake of time, I'll jump straight to the solution. I'll hop onto switch 1. And let's see the issue. Enable. Show interface G00. Down at the bottom, check out the statistics listed here. 10 giants. Those are the pings I just tried to send. They fit within the MTUs of R1, the ISP, and R2, but it seems they surpassed the Ethernet MTU of Switch 1's G00 interface. At the top of this output, you can see the MTU. 1400 bytes. That's why the pings failed. Switch 1's G00 has a 1400 byte MTU, and even if the DF bit isn't set on the packet, if a message surpasses an interface's Ethernet MTU, the only choice it has is to drop it. Layer 2 doesn't provide any fragmentation capabilities. Let's check Switch 1's interface configurations. Show running config, pipe, and then section interface. The section keyword can be used to show a certain section of the output. As you can see here, both G00 and G01 have an MTU of 1400 configured. Let's return them to the default. Conf T, interface range G00 to 1, no MTU. End. Okay, let's double check. Show interface G00. Okay, the MTU is 1500 now. And then G01, show interface G01. 1500 here too. Perfect. Let's return to R1 again and try a 1476 byte ping. Ping 192.168.23.3, size 1476. Okay, this time the ping works. Okay, that's all for this lab. In this lab, we reviewed some of the MTU concepts covered in the previous lecture video, and also did a bit of troubleshooting. Make sure to spend some time experimenting in your own lab, too. Ask questions, and try to find the answers yourself in the lab. It's a great way to learn. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. Before finishing this video, let me thank my JCNP level channel members. To become a member, please click the Join button under the video. Thanks to Jonathan Makara, Boson Software, Velva Jacob, George Streeter, Funny Dart, Nasir Chowdhury, Devin Suku, Gustavo BR, Gerard Baker, Marcel Lord, Pavel M., Mr. Erlison, Drago Cernea, Zakib Shah, Mayor Salman, Mazen Anderson, Vitaus 194, Gina Lindley, Nehemia, Justin Watke, Bold 1C1U, Mark Jackson, Michael Carroll, Gerald Guillaume, Gabriel Braga, Renan Marias, Hector Hernandez, Ali Polat, Maratuba, Roji Kuriakos, Owad, Arpad Conives, 5 Feet, Daniel Brown, Emiliano Correa, Tricky Mickey 123456, Scott Thompson, Jose Alvarez, Kevin Hayes, Hussein Yavuz, Samuel Tavares, Mustafa Ersoy, Nasser Zahar, Dear Diso, Alexandru Badic, Brian Grant, Georgi Gemejev, Ahmed Ismail, Dibia Swain, Tan No, Arlen Plagaria, and Adelson Pereira. Sorry if I pronounced your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. Thanks to you and my other supporters, I am able to make these videos and release them for free on YouTube, so I really appreciate the support. Another great way to support the channel is to like the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and most importantly, share this video with others. So, if this video was helpful, I'd appreciate it if you did any of those. Thanks for watching.